you came in, the air went out. And every shadow filled up with doubt. I don't know who you think you are, but before the night is through, I wanna do bad things with you. I'm the kind to sit up in his room, heart sick and eyes filled up with blue. I don't know what you've done to me, but I know this much is true.
Anyway, okay, so we once again are tired of waiting on season 5 to start.
Because waiting sucks.
Yes, we are a little obsessed and maybe a little anxious.
Crazy.
To get going here. So we want to do a few for the next few Sundays because we've only got, after last night, which was Sunday, we've only got 3 more Sundays to go before Game of Thrones is over and True Blood starts.
And the book has come out as well.
Yes, we're gonna talk about that next week. But once again, for the premiere, I bought concert tickets months ago, bought them for a Christmas present. They announce in, April, when True Blood is going to premiere, and it turns out to be the same night that I have tickets for a concert. So
she's not allowed to go to concerts next year.
So David and I and Brandon will all be at the Roger Waters concert, and we'll have to watch the premiere day late again this year. So,
did you notice she didn't say Missy? Because number one, Missy's not going to the concert. Wasn't invited.
Did you want to go see Roger Waters?
No.
I didn't think so.
Number two, Missy has not promised to not watch True Blood.
Missy's not watching it until we watch it. But anyway.
She thinks she's the boss of me.
So, okay, it's a few things have changed. Some of you who are in the bookies group already know this, but some of you don't. So, Missy, what's new in your life since last year when we filmed for True Blood?
Let me think. I have a baby. Have a baby named Vaughn. He's 4 months old today.
Which he's just very cute.
He just went in the house. Why did we let him go in the house before we started?
I'll show pictures. They'll see
and him. And I want to see. You will see him a lot. He's a bit attached to me the way I am to True Blood, but I am more attached to him.
And then I graduated Saturday.
Yay.
So I'm not taking classes this summer for the first summer in 4 years. I am not taking classes this year.
More than 4.
More than 4? Mm-hmm. I know the whole time I've been at U of L.
But you did it in Florida too, so I would say about 6 years.
Yeah. Because I didn't go to school for 4 years and get done. I had to work the whole time, so it took me a little longer. But anyway, I graduated.
So we're proud of her.
Woo!
She thinks she's really new now.
So we're going to go over some of the Waiting Sucks videos and the little teasers we've been given. And the two...
And she got a haircut.
Yeah, I got my haircut. And the two promos. Okay, so the first one we saw wasn't a big win. It was just a few seconds, and this is it. Okay, so you notice on that they did not say the premiere date. So there you go. I bought the tickets before I knew.
Anyway.
And what new information did we get from that little teaser? Let's talk about that.
I don't think we got new information. We knew last year.
Well, but I think there's more than just, there's Russell. We know Russell's back.
Oh, well, yeah,
for
but
sure.
Yeah, and that everybody, we figured out and then they eventually tell you.
Yeah, so
everybody's
a lot of things
past is coming about back to haunt them.
Yeah, everybody's past is coming back. So that was the
you
first one.
You got ghosts in your closet.
And so that was the first one. And then the second one.
Go on in. Good luck getting out.
Bill Compton. It has been a while.
I'm mainstreaming.
This feels like what Vampire Bar would look like if it were a ride at Disney World.
She wanted to die. Everyone who comes here does.
Sookie Steckhouse, well, aren't you sweet?
Not really.
Trouble abounds in your affairs,
dear. They'll have no fury like a vampire queen broke move. The blood.
She may well be the last of her kind. Your only chance to walk in the sun.
You are way too beautiful to be alone here.
I'm here with my boyfriend.
Bring me his fangs, or I will have yours.
Everything ends. Even the immortals.
How can someone named Sookie take him away from me?
I knew I shouldn't have trust you!
You're right.
How long have you been here?
I got no idea.
There's a new authority in town!
Say hello to the true death.
Okay, so once again, they're just letting us know that a lot of stuff from
which
the regular characters past
anyway.
Are coming back. Russell, of course, was the big one, but apparently...
I don't think Russell really is the big one. I mean, he's a big person, but I think we're going to learn a lot about Eric and stuff.
Yeah, Eric and Pam's relationship, Pam being made. We've read, some articles that say that's going to be this season. We don't look at a lot of the spoilers. Some of you, the things that we talk about here, you guys may already know things that we're wondering about. If you do, don't tell us.
No.
We don't want to know. We don't want to know any more than what we already know.
Because we believe there's only going to be a year or two more of True Blood. And
a year. After this one. A year after this one.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
So we need to stretch it out as long as we can. Because, I don't know if you all knew this, but Kentucky won a championship. And it's already over. And now, next year is going to begin, and somebody else is going to be champion. So,
yeah,
things go by very quickly.
okay, so those were the two teasers, just basically letting us know that a lot of things.
I really
from
liked
the past
how they did the
back.
Bars, though.
Okay, so then we had, I think the next one. Yeah, so the next one that we had was actually a trailer. We got to see some of the things that were going to happen this year. So. And
is this,
was
the
a big
one we came up so obsessed with?
That we, yeah, I have screen caps. Let me say before we look at the screen caps, I know how bad my screen caps are. My software was free, so they're not beautiful.
Is this the very first one we've seen?
This was the very first
one. Okay, let me tell you. David is like this. David loves True Blood. It is his favorite show besides Sons of Anarchy and Game of Thrones. That's True Blood's favorite. But he watches an episode, he watches previews, and then that's it. He does not understand the obsession with pausing screen by screen by screen by screen. And my mother totally, our mom totally doesn't.
Mom's worried about us. She thinks they're going to commit us.
Yeah, vampire.
Over vampires.
Yeah, some kind of vampire thing. But so, this so obsessed us for...
A whole week. I mean, we rewatched this.
No, it was
this.
Longer than a week. Because we were like arguing over what things were and... Who was what, and who had what clothes on.
I still have a question about it, too. Okay, so here was the first trailer that we got to see.
We were created in God's image, not humans. And their flesh shall nourish yours. Their blood shall flow within you. For as the beetle nourishes the lark, so shall human nourish vampire.
So the first shot that you see, Sookie is burying something in her backyard with...
Which Carissa argued with me for 2 days.
I didn't
know
if that was Sookie's house. That's awfully big to be Sookie's house. I didn't
Eric
think
built
house
on.
Was that big. But anyway, so Sookie and a guy are burying something. Say what you think of that picture.
I thought it was Tara.
That they're burying Tara?
Because it was so close to the house, and I didn't think she would bury Debbie Pelt so close to the house. And they would be taking the Eric, getting rid of Debbie Pelt from her again, which they probably will do anyway. But I don't think that they would bury Debbie Pelt that close to the house.
I have changed my mind. I don't think that's Lafayette. She's burying somebody with...
Do you think that's Tara?
Do I think that's Tara in the hole?
That's a man.
I don't think... I don't know if it's Tara. I have a question about that. I don't know if it's Tara or not.
How can it be Debbie? Why would you put Debbie Pelt that
close? I don't think
close?
She would put Debbie Pelt that close. I'm so all, it's somebody else? I think else? It could be Tara. I think it could be Tara. But that's not Lafayette she's burying her with. And I don't know
you're
who
the
it
one
is
that
in that
was
hole.
So, you were the one that so convinced yep. that was Lafayette.
And I'm going to show you later why I now think that it's
okay, but I don't think that that's Debbie Pelt in that hole. If it is, then...
They're stupid for burying Debbie Pelt so close to the house. House.
Yeah, the writers were stupid. So if we're wrong about that, that's their stupidity. Okay, there's her looking at, that right there is why I don't think that's Lafayette.
Because of the way she's looking
because
at him?
Because of the way she's looking at him.
Okay. Interesting.
And she's got blood on her hands.
Well, she's going to have blood on her
okay,
hands.
Okay, but that means Tara. She didn't even get rid of the blood. Any, I mean, that was unfair. This has to be something that happens very quickly. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Okay, so then we saw a girl with Eric and Bill. At first I thought that might be Jessica, but now that we've seen that there's some dark-haired girl coming on the show.
Well, and that he was smooching her.
We haven't seen that.
Oh, okay. Yes, we just seen it.
But, so they're walking through some kind of...
We know who she is.
...dungeon. Can we talk about things?
Oh, okay.
Time, please?
It's not a dungeon.
Whatever the hell that is.
It's an underground cavern, maybe.
Then, I don't know what this is going on with Bill. What this does tell me about season 5 is that Bill's still not in Peru. They're still waiting for you in Peru, Bill. Okay, so then we see Arlene looking frightened.
Frightened?
Yes.
In her little fleecy gown?
Yes. It's not a fleece, it's a nightgown.
I'm just kidding.
And standing over top of Arlene.
But that is not... Terry in her bedroom, because if their bedroom looks like that, I want to know how they got that in that little house of Sam's.
They're not staying in the house of Sam's. It burned down.
Well, that's not a house.
They're staying in the Bellflower Mansion with Andy.
That is not the Bellflower Mansion.
Why? It's just moonlight coming in through the window making shadows.
I do not believe. Okay, that is a lamp, isn't it? I thought he was walking down a hallway.
I think he's standing over early. Something's definitely going on with Terry.
But I don't know that he's standing over Arlene.
Okay.
I don't know.
Maybe not. You know how they put things together to make us think things, and then that's not what it is. Okay, then Jessica.
Okay, I think she's feeding on this guy, and then she gets a thought about
something. A feeling.
Yeah.
About something to do with Jason.
Yeah, we think it's Jason. Okay. She's floozied up.
She's not.
She is.
I don't like this.
And there's death. That's after the explosion. So that's after the explosion.
What exploded, though? What do you think?
It was a car. I thought a car bomb. Okay, so that means it's like...
Is this from the same explosion?
I think so, and I think it's at the end of the year, and it's like at the big climax of the season, so I'm really pissed.
They never give us things from the end of the year on the original.
You know, I don't mean the last one. I mean, like, towards the end of the year.
Anyway, I don't
What's
like
her
this
name?
Picture. I don't remember.
She's his sister. No.
Yes.
Yeah, she's his sister. That's the next morning after Tara and Debbie Pelt.
After they've buried whoever it is that they buried.
And Tara and Debbie Pelt.
Yeah. We believe. And then you see Jason opening his door.
To...
And on the other side of the door. Now, we saw this at the end of season 4. There's Steve Newland. I want to know how he gets in that house. Does he glamour Jason into letting him
That's the only way he can get in into the house. Because he showed him his fangs.
Yes.
You know why he's there, can I say?
Why do you think he's there?
Because Jason told him he didn't be to heaven.
He's going to come back and get Jason for that.
See, look at how he's looking at
he's
Jason.
He's letting him in the house. So
look at
I
Jason's
want to know how
eyes. Look at Jason's eyes and his eyes. That's how. Look.
Yeah. Lafayette, and he's wearing that shirt.
And what
with
does
the
that
hood.
Mean?
That's Dia de los Muertos.
And I ask you what it
day
meant.
Of the day. So
which
Hispanic
that's
Hispanic celebration.
Okay, so Halloween was when that other stuff happened.
Yes, and Day of the Dead is
what
the day after Halloween.
So this is so he already had his house ready for it.
Yes.
So we know this isn't too long after.
Right.
So there could be no year went by this time.
No. So we know it's right there together. He's also wearing a shirt with a hood. which is what originally made me think, well, that has to be Lafayette there burying whoever that is.
His
with
hair
Sookie.
Is different again.
His hair is different. Well,
no, it's different. Right. Yeah, it is.
But anyway, I'm starting to think maybe, no, that's not Lafayette out there, and I'll show you.
Okay, who is this?
Okay, these are obviously the werewolf people who are
what
mad
the hell does
about
he got
Marcus's
on his head?
Death.
Oh, and he's bleeding.
He's covered in blood.
What has he got on his head?
I don't know, but we know that if these are the people who showed up at Sam's house at the end of season 4, that's not going to last very long, because we've already seen a scene with Sam, and he's with Luna.
Yeah, but I don't know. I don't remember him having that on. Maybe I'm wrong, but I don't remember him having that on.
So maybe that does come, like, later in the season.
She's been crying.
Yes.
But she's not at Fantasia.
She's not at Fantasia.
She's dressed very properly.
I think she's at Sookie's house. And then we saw Eric. And this is Eric from before. This is Eric.
No.
It has to be. Look at the hair.
That's Bill.
Yeah.
So this is Eric from before. No, I think he was.
This is Eric remembering something, I think. Because that is Eric. That's Amnesia Eric. Look at the hair. And we've seen this a lot. The man being drugged down the hallway.
That's for Russell.
Yeah, we think that's probably they've got Russell kept in this room. And, you know, you see the blood splatter on the windows. We've seen that a lot. That's how I think they're keeping Russell alive. So, what is Steve going to do to Jason?
I just, you know, it really would be funny if they made Jason a vampire because, A, he could be with Jessica.
It would drive Jessica crazy. She said she did not want it. She didn't want to have any kind of committed relationship.
And they didn't make him a, and they didn't make him
a werewolf or a panther. Yeah. I think that Steve is going to hurt Jason. Jessica's going to know it.
She's going to save him.
She's going to save him, and she's going to have to turn him into a vampire. Then she's a maker.
And is that who they're burying? Is that your she would bury Jason that close to that.
And I think that is who it is, and I'll show you why.
Well, and we've thought that about Jason for a while because of this Jason and Jessica thing and everything, and because they didn't make him into a werepanther.
Yes.
Ooh, don't tell David that, because he worries about Jason too much. Okay. Now that's Bill's.
She's at Bill's. Yeah. I don't know what that's about.
That's Lafayette.
That's Lafayette and Allsene.
Oh, fighting in Sookie's kitchen.
Yes. And I thought at first maybe Lafayette was like channeling Debbie Pelt because he's a medium and that's why he's fighting Allsene.
Lafayette's
but now we know
pissed.
That that's not true.
Lala is mad. I guess he's changing.
Sam's going to change.
Now this is when he's standing outside his trailer.
Is that where that is? Yeah. Outside his trailer? Okay.
It has to be. That's a trailer, isn't it?
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Does other people do this?
I don't know. I think so.
Now look at this. This is some dead-ass vampires.
There's a whole bunch of dead vampires around. Bill, Eric,
look at the body
and that woman
there.
Again. But I want you to pay attention to that face. Okay?
His?
No, hers.
Okay, that's our Eric,
with the hair slicked back. That's Eric now. That's why I'm saying the one with his hair all forward.
I get that, but that could have been right after, immediately after they killed Nan, and he went some, he, listen.
Could have been.
And then Bill comes and says, the authority's after us.
We'll find out.
Okay. That is
Terry.
Yeah, that's Terry.
Somebody's punching Terry.
And he is
not happy.
No. Okay, there's Sookie.
Sookie's screaming again, so.
Leave her alone. She's had a rough few years.
Sookie deserves some peace, I think.
With Eric. A piece of Eric.
There's Lafayette, and he has a knife. Now, is that what he went to sleep in? Because remember, Sookie put him to bed after.
I don't remember him having purple on, though. Because he has a gown on.
But he is staying in Sookie's spare bedroom.
Yeah, but I think he lives with Sookie now. I think I've seen that on the bookies group. Somebody told. There's Bill.
There's Bill. Somebody's threatening to cut Bill. Just send him to Peru. You don't have to cut him.
It's the true death.
It's the true death.
That's a girl.
You think?
Look. That's a leg. That's a leg bent over.
That's maybe an arm.
That's a guy's hand and watch. But that's a girl. There's the explosion.
And then there's an explosion. It isn't a parking lot.
The explosion.
Looks like it is cars.
It's a car, some kind of car bomb, I believe.
No, okay. We went over and over and over this.
Is that the end of it?
Had all kinds of theories. I believe so, yeah. And then at least one of my theories has definitely changed.
This is the first, actually, on location.
This is the first waiting sucks we got.
1.47, Delta 1.
What's going on that you couldn't just call?
It's Russell Edgington, sir. He's on the loose.
On the loose? Russell Edgington's dead.
You mean they never told you?
Never told me what?
Those motherfuckers. Russell's gonna come after you, which is why you have to come stay with me.
I can't.
Sookie, get the fuck out of here, Wolf. The fuck is his problem? I'm sorry about you and your boyfriend, but I'm here because Sookie's in danger.
I heard. I've been listening. How the fuck you think you're gonna protect her from an ancient, pissed off vampire when all werewolves do is get vampires even more pissed off? We're done with all this supernatural bullshit. You heard me? No vampires, no ghosts, no witches, no maenads, and no fucking werewolves. Why don't y'all just get the fuck up out of our lives,
I'm throwing you a lifeline here. Please take it.
Like I said, I can't.
Okay, so we learned...
So, Lafayette, he doesn't have hair in that, and he does have hair later. I know his
Unless
hair
Unless he's remembering something from the day that Jesus died.
Could be.
Okay. So...
Wait a minute. This is Vaughn.
Say hi. We had a tech break. Vaughn was not happy.
Look, Vaughn Yvonne. Say hi. My name is Vaughn. And I am the bestest baby in the world until I get mad.
Okay, so... We learned a couple of things. We learned a couple of things from that video. We learned, number one, that Russell is definitely on the loose. He has escaped. And Alcide knows about it. Okay.
And Sookie didn't.
Right.
Which we knew they never told her that they buried him alive.
And then we saw Lafayette get really mad and say he didn't want supernatural people around him and Sookie anymore. So, I want to show you something.
You know, I've already thought about that, though.
Wait a minute. So, Alcide says it's Russell Edgington. He's on the loose. So, Russell is definitely back.
What did you think?
Alcide says Russell's going to come after you, which is why you have to come stay with me. Sookie says, not, I don't want to do that, or I'll be fine here, or any of those things. She says, twice, I can't.
I know, because there's somebody buried in her yard that's going to come back alive.
Which only takes one night, so that would be the next day. After that person was buried. And Lafayette doesn't have hair.
I don't understand what you
said. So maybe it's not the next day after she killed Debbie Pelt.
So that would mean it wouldn't be Tara.
Yeah.
It would be Jason.
Right.
So what do you think? He tortured Jason for a couple days?
Maybe. And Lafayette says, we're done with all this supernatural bullshit. No vampires. No ghosts, no witches, no maenads, and no fucking werewolves. No vampires.
Oh, so you're saying Lafayette doesn't know that there's a vampire out in his yard.
Right, out in Sookie's yard.
He's trying to get you to pay attention.
I have to do a video here. So there's the person with the hood. It is the exact same jacket that Lafayette has on later.
But he could have picked that up.
He could have. This person is also...
Oh, please let it be Eric. Please let it. But if it's Eric, then who's she buried with? Oh, it's Jessica.
Jessica. And I think that's Eric. It's too tall.
Wait a minute.
To
maybe
be Lafayette.
Well, I said that in the beginning and you said bullshit. Say it. Tell him I was right.
I said it was too tall to be Lafayette. And then I said no because it's the same jacket.
Maybe Lafayette doesn't know that Tara's buried in the yard. It could be either
then
one.
Then that can't be him burying her.
Okay, that's my point. But then it would have to be Bill, because if that's Eric, then that would have to be Bill.
Says who? Maybe it's Jessica in there.
She didn't come and save, she didn't come and save Tara. I'm talking about if it's Tara.
Okay, look how short Lafayette is compared to Alcide.
Right.
Lafayette is not very tall. Not like that person who's burying whoever that is.
I agree. I said it was Eric from the beginning and you said no. So don't give me no crap, Aunt Krista.
I give you a nut to say.
Lafayette doesn't know there's something out in the yard. Regardless of if it's Tara or Jason, either one, he didn't know.
So then we had the Waiting Sucks video with Sam and Luna. So whoever was at Sam's house at the end of season four hasn't killed him.
Do you know anybody who would want to hurt them?
No. They were wonderful people. Oh, God.
I want to know how I can be here for you. What was that?
Nothing. Emma's been having some trouble sleeping.
Right. I'm gonna check on you tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay.
I think I know who this is, and I don't trust her.
I don't either.
I think they're talking about the people that they were friends with, that they became horses with.
Maybe.
Lips.
And she just explained that noise away a little too easily.
What did
she say? Oh, it's nothing. He said, what's that noise? And she said, her little girl, what is her name? Emma?
Emma.
Emma's been having trouble sleeping, and just kind of brushes it off. Then we had the Waiting Sucks with Terry. Something definitely weird going on.
With Terry and the...
Patrick.
The army dude.
Yes.
Okay, Mark.
Get against the wall.
Eller, come on, man.
Get your heads against the wall and your hands behind your back. Turn.
Did anything follow you here?
Eller?
Did anything follow
Eller.
You here?
Hey, Mark.
I'm beginning to think that maybe this was a not so great idea. How long do you think he's been out here?
A couple of years at least. Man, he has really lost his fucking shit. Eller.
I'm real sorry for what I gotta do.
Jesus fuck, for the love of God, Eller,
please. If I kill you, it will forgive me.
Eller, you do not have to do this.
Who needs to forgive you?
It's called the evil. And it's coming for us.
These are longer than what we got to see.
Those
on...
are the extended versions.
Yeah. See, why didn't you tell me that? Because you keep showing me.
I just found them.
Yeah, but you keep showing me stuff I never seen before, and I'm like...
So, Terry's in trouble. And they kept saying, did anything follow you, not did anyone follow you.
And so, I don't know if that is a... Where?
I don't know.
I don't think so, or he wouldn't have said that.
Yeah. Then we had the Waiting Sucks with Eric and Pam.
This was a difficult one.
This was very sad.
I had a hard time with this.
Feeling Mark?
You're fucking lying.
I'm not lying. I swear I don't know where Russell is.
What's happened to you? How could you think I would go and dig up Russell Edgington?
I trust no one. You shouldn't either.
Margaret.
A century together. And never once have I ever done anything to hurt you. To hurt us.
If you can't trust me more than Bill Compton, or a werewolf for Christ's sake, then release me and get it over with. Just say the words as your maker. I release you. Say it and we're done. Say it!
Okay, wait.
That was very sad.
And, he's very torn.
Yeah.
And they have a, it's really bad between them.
Yeah.
But Godric released him.
Mm-hmm.
Godric released his sister. Mm-hmm. I just can't see Eric ever releasing her.
I don't know. That one was pretty hard.
With the whole Sookie, what did she call her? The fairy slit or what she
fairy
called?
Fairy vagina.
Didn't she call her a slit? No. Sorry. Yeah.
Yeah.
A fairy.
So if he's still that mad at Pam over Sookie.
He thinks Pam is still that mad at Sookie and would release Russell to kill Sookie is what he thinks.
Yes.
That's what he is.
Okay, and then we got this one. This one was just funny.
How long does this game go on for?
We played a 5 million.
You're acting like a century-old child.
Relax!
If you don't love me, I will die.
Then die!
You just killed my fairy godmother!
Sorry.
Sorry. I thought that was so funny. I think they should have showed Franklin.
Okay, and then we got this really odd one.
SVU.
Christopher Maloney.
No, he was also in the prison show.
Oh, yeah.
And he was bad. What was the prison show that we loved on HBO?
Oz.
The Oz SVU dude.
So I was thinking, is this the Authority? Is this just some ancient vampire? I had no idea, but it was sure pretty
last time it
strange.
Was... No, they pretty much said last night.
Yeah, they said in this new one, this is definitely the Authority.
But I can't figure out what this is. Are they giving her powers? I don't know. I can't really.
Turning her into a vampire, maybe?
She's already. But that's not how you turn somebody into a vampire.
No, so we know that this guy is going to be a big deal this year.
He is the big deal.
So that one was pretty odd. Okay.
It wasn't odd. It was fascinating.
Now, this is the trailer that we got last night.
The end may come soon. Either Russell will have our heads, or the Authority will.
Russell wants nothing more than anarchy.
We'll bring him in, or die trying.
Sookie could be useful.
I don't think she wants anything to do with us again.
I don't think we give her the choice.
Your life is on the line here. I get you're tough, but that don't mean you have to be stupid.
Vampires. We've been getting away with these killings forever. Humans should be farmed like cattle.
It's wonderful to be a vampire, isn't it?
We come to finish what we started.
We are the Authority. I am the Authority. If we continue to behave like savages,
the humans will rise up.
My dad's the king.
Not anymore.
We're all gonna die.
I'm sick of lying and covering and ruining people's lives.
You the angel of death.
They will suffer.
Okay, that's the beginning.
Okay, so we know what happens at the beginning of the season. Tara has been shot. I still just don't think that's Tara.
What is
at
that?
All.
That's Lafayette.
That's Lafayette waking up. He's still got hair and he's got that hoodie on.
Okay.
Bill's still not in Peru.
Sorry, baby. Sorry, baby. We're almost done. Okay, there's... Is that the red door you're talking about?
No, I think that's in that room where the authority was.
Okay. There's... Is that Jess? That's that girl.
Jessica.
Yeah, I guess it's Jessica.
I don't know what that's about.
There's
Pam.
Pam
looks beautiful.
She does look beautiful. She's in that bed. Is she laying in the bed?
Yeah, I think. No, she was in a coffin opening her eyes. Now, who's all seen all red-eyed at?
Sook?
Maybe.
It's outside.
Sam has a crossbow.
I can't see no crossbow.
He has a crossbow in his hand.
She's scared.
Arlene is very scared.
She's scared all the time. She's scared of making babies. See, that's too many times.
Okay. I mean, maybe it's not Jason.
It's not
but
Jason.
I don't think it's Tara.
Okay, why is
what
he dressed like
that? What the hell
is
Flint dressed in golf clothes for? Maybe because he wants to be a fang banger.
He is a fang banger.
Who's cooking behind all the fire? Is that
LaFette? That's that mask.
Is that mask?
Yep. Who's that?
I don't know.
Stop it.
I don't know who that is. That is either Terry or Jason.
Maybe it's the new guy. Terry or that new guy. What's his name?
Patrick?
It's not Jason. You should know you dream about Jason.
Bunch of dead people. I don't know what
that's
from.
That
has to
be vampires.
From there.
That's
no, not dead vampires. Maybe from the explosion.
Stop that.
That's in the hospital that they were talking about was a scene on True Blood this year.
Okay, and this is where I thought Terry was walking.
It's not.
I think that's Bill. Well, in the fifth book, Bill is in a hospital.
How is Bill
no,
in the hospital?
No, Sookie's in the hospital.
Yeah. I think that's Bill. Look at the hair. Burning.
Why would he be burning in there?
The windows? Sunlight coming through the windows?
Maybe. Go ahead.
There's the fairies.
Okay. Claude.
Uh-huh.
Who's the other one?
I have no idea.
Okay. I have some questions.
Okay.
Here we go. That's not Claude that we know.
No. They said they were going to be... It was going to be a different person.
No. What I'm saying is... Unless I'm missing something, that ain't the hot stripper Claude.
No, it's not
going to happen. Why not? Okay, so do we know if Claude's good or bad?
I don't know yet.
Okay. What do you know about Claude?
I don't know anything other than it's not going to be the same guy playing him that we saw the first time.
Okay, what is she? That is not the first night. Is that the first night?
I don't know.
Let's guess. I thought that's what we were doing here.
I don't know because I can't tell where it is. But obviously something really bad has happened.
We're going to have to go over these again. Who's watching him?
It's either Pam or Sookie.
Okay.
Or maybe the new woman.
That is just a beautiful scene even. I mean, just to know that they were that close, and I like that.
Yeah.
Makes me feel sorry for Pam now. She likes girls though. But what is it? He gives good strength.
Yeah, it pulls good strength. That's Eric talking to Sookie outside of Sookie's house, maybe?
No, because that's a metal bar.
Yeah.
That's not her porch. And that's where he was explaining to her that
the authority is coming after him. Yeah.
And you notice she's talking to him.
Yes.
I haven't seen her with Bill.
No. Is that the same girl that is the sister?
Ooh.
And she's part of the authority?
Well, then Godric wouldn't have changed her. Stop that. That's when... This is where they get them.
Yeah, apparently the authority
now,
has
see,
Bill
his
and
hair
Eric.
Isn't slick in that one.
It's just pushed to the side, yeah. But the authority apparently gets Bill and Eric at some point.
Well, that's what this whole season's going to be about. I think the past and that. There's Sookie
with Bill and Eric.
Look how much taller he is than Bill.
Yeah.
Lord
but,
mercy.
I mean, obviously, whatever it is they wanted Sookie
okay,
to be part of, she's going to be
okay,
a part of it.
Okay, wait a minute. This is, there's somebody behind them, too. This is the night where you see all of them walking, right?
Yes.
And she's kind of got black on as well. But all the other scenes we've seen, she's not with them.
Right.
What is she doing?
I have no idea. Now, who is that?
Jessica.
And? Who's she biting?
I don't think it's anybody we know.
Maybe not. kind of looks like Sookie, doesn't
but
it?
But it's not.
You don't think?
No, it's definitely not.
Okay, can I just say that, you know, most men don't look good like this, but...
I'm not saying anything.
He looks great like this.
I'm not saying anything. Wait a minute. Like I will say this. We've seen some before that may have looked this good, but not quite this good.
Now, this is... Isn't that the same girl that was with the authority dude? And she's talking to Eric.
She's with the... Yeah, that's the girl who was with the authority dude, but I don't think that's...
Is this the sister?
No, I don't think so. That girl's nose looks different, but I don't know for sure. That's Sookie and Bill behind him. Who's he bending over?
I don't know. Why are his fangs out?
Right. That is definitely Sookie and Bill behind him. Okay, they're all bowing to that right there, which is some the blood of that woman. That's who's going to be in there this year, right? The very first...
Salome.
Salome.
You think it's the blood of Salome that they're all bowing to?
Right?
Could be.
Isn't she going to be there this year?
Yes.
That's the authority.
He's talking to the authority. I think that's the woman.
Yeah.
Is that Eric?
I don't know. Who's the little kid?
Somebody in the authority.
That's a big deal, though.
That little kids can become vampires?
Know that they could become vampires and be in the authority. That's Eric. Oh, that's Eric.
Is that Eric?
Oh, yeah, Krissa. That's Eric.
So they're going to get Eric in a silver net?
They said they had to get the rogue vampires. That is Eric. Look at that. That is Eric.
The chest?
Yeah, don't you think?
It's possible.
Krissa, no, come on.
We know the authority
the
gets
face.
Them at some point. Is this how they did it?
See, look at her fish. That's Bill!
Is that the same woman that's in the authority?
Yeah, that looks more
Is it
like
the
her.
Sister?
No.
I want it to be the sister.
That's the girl in the authority.
Go kiss on Bill, sister.
Huh. That's Sookie. She...
She is going to learn how to...
No, they make it look like she knocks down Eric.
Maybe.
They do. They make it look like she goes, and then Eric goes flying somewhere, but I don't know if the two of them things go together. Because the car bomb could go off, and that's what makes Eric fly.
Could be.
Do you have that in here?
I don't know.
Wait a minute. There's Jessica and him, and that is not, yes, that isn't, that could be in Jason's house.
Yes.
Right there.
And she
no,
says.
No, he doesn't have the same outfit on.
Okay. And she says, my dad is the king. And Steve Newland says, not anymore.
She did? See, it was too late for me.
Yeah.
So who's
Bill's
the king?
Not king anymore? I don't know.
Okay, now that was something I wanted to ask you about.
That's the Brujo thing that Jesus could channel.
Okay, but Jesus is dead.
Yes. But can't Lafayette still channel him?
I don't know that.
Jesus was dead when Lafayette looked like that while Eric and Bill were tied to the stake. But he was taken over by Marnie.
I don't want Vaughn to see that.
Is this Lafayette?
No, he's too wide. Don't you think?
No.
I don't want Vaughn to see that.
I don't. That's Andy.
Who's that girl?
That's Debbie Pelt.
Oh, it is. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So Andy
she
is
looks
looking
much prettier
for
like
who
that.
Killed Debbie Pelt.
Damn, she looks prettier like that.
She's a very pretty girl. Just not when she's Debbie. And yep. Now... This is why we don't like Alcine. So then we have Hoyt dressed as some kind of girl.
Is he trying to be a vampire?
Maybe. Maybe.
I didn't see this.
Hoyt is dressed in some kind of goth getup, and somebody's attacking
no,
him.
No, I don't really want Hoyt to be a vampire.
And then the final shot we saw, Russell is definitely back. I, for one, am very glad. I thought Russell was funny.
You want him to kill the Sook?
No, they can kill him, but I get a whole season of...
Who's going to kill him? Well, we know who's going to kill him. Okay, so let's discuss.
Okay, so anyway, so the conversation goes, Bill's talking about him and Eric going to find Russell Edgington. And Bill says Sookie could be useful. And Eric says, I don't think she wants to have anything to do with us. And Bill says,
I don't think we give her a choice.
So there you go. Bill obviously doesn't care about Sookie's wants as much as Eric does. I mean, that was pretty.
Is this a moment? Is this a come to Jesus moment?
That was pretty. Yeah, he. So obviously, we haven't really made any firm decisions other than the fact that I don't think Tara's going to survive. I don't think that's Tara buried out there. If it is, Lafayette doesn't know it. Obviously. Any other big thoughts?
Not before? Jason.
You don't think it's Jason?
No.
For sure.
No. And if it is Tara, it's because they didn't tell Lafayette.
Maybe. Then who's she out there burying Tara with?
It would have to be, if that's Eric helping her, it would have to be Bill, which is going to piss me off. Because Bill would want to be a maker to somebody else, which Bill would probably do it for Sookie, just to try to get her good graces. But, I don't know if Eric would, because of all, I don't know. Eric would do it if Sookie wanted him to. Yeah. Bill would too.
Right.
I was trying to think what had happened that night, if one of them would be stronger than the other. I just don't know why Eric would let Bill do it. Unless Bill just got over there first, but Eric's quicker. So I don't know.
I don't know either.
I just cannot see that she buried Debbie Pelt out there.
No, and we're very hung up on that right now, on who is it that she's burying and why, and who is it that's
helping her. I think that's a very big turn. That is an integral right, part of the show, or they wouldn't have showed that first.
Right.
And
then shown it again in the second trailer.
But in the first trailer, she looked kind of scared. In the second one, she was crying while she was doing it. That's why I kind of thought it was Tara. But, I mean, if she was burying Tara there and just burying her body, I mean, she could say Debbie Pelt shot Tara.
Yeah.
You know, because that is who shot Tara.
Yeah.
So, I mean, she could call, you know, Andy and say she shot Tara and I had to shoot her because she shot Tara. So that's why I'm thinking if they're looking for Debbie and they're hiding Debbie, there's something more to it. But if Tara comes back, then that wouldn't make any sense either.
I don't know.
I'm beginning to think that that's not Tara. Well, that Tara's not going to come back. Because I don't know why they wouldn't just tell the authorities. not the authority. But like Andy and the cops, you know, this is what happened. And they didn't show anything in there about Andy and his fairy love children. But
we don't know that he has love children yet.
That's what she wanted.
I think so.
The fact that they showed two boy fairies this time.
Yes.
Means they're going to get them some women.
So obviously we don't know yet what what we're really thinking.
As you see, we're jumbled.
We're still theorizing.
We had theories.
Yeah.
And then they totally blew them out of the water.
Messed us all up. Okay, so you realize we have 3 weeks left. Three more Sundays.
I know, because I'm going to be here the night.
Between now and the premiere.
I'm
going
to just have to sit here with my baby.
I don't know what you've done to me, but I know this much is true. I want to do bad things with you. Okay. I don't know what you've done to me, but I know this much is true. I want to do bad things with you.